Hi students, this is Alex here. In this video, we are going to diagonalize the given matrix A by an orthogonal transformation. And hence, we are going to find A power 4. And this matrix A is symmetric matrix. When I find A transpose, writing the rows as a column, so I'm going to write the first row 8 minus 6, 2 as a first column, which is 8 minus 6, 2. Then second row minus 6, 7 and minus 4 as second column. Then third row as third column. We get A transpose, and this A transpose and A both are same. Therefore, this given matrix A is a symmetric. It is a symmetric matrix. So this orthogonal transformation is possible only if the given matrix is a symmetric matrix. Now we have to write the characteristic equation. It is the determinant A minus lambda I equal to 0. Now 8 minus lambda minus 6, 2, then minus 6, 7 minus lambda minus 4, then 2 minus 4 and 3 minus lambda. This determinant value we are equating to 0. Now we are going to do the expansion. So take the first element 8 minus lambda and we have to expand this one. So this will give 7 minus lambda into 3 minus lambda and minus of this product is 16. So we have to subtract anyway. Bracket close. And the next one, we take the opposite sign. Here we take negative sign. Already there is a negative 6. So to become plus 6, then this product minus 6 into this. So minus 18 plus 6 lambda and minus of minus 4 into 2. It is minus 8. So already there is a minus. So to become plus. And the last term is plus 2 into it is minus 6 minus 4, which is minus 24, and minus of product of this. So 7 to 14, already there is a minus, so become plus 2 lambda, equating this to 0. Now, the first term 8 minus lambda as it is, we go for expansion of this. So 21 minus 7 lambda, then minus 3 lambda. Plus lambda square minus 16. Then combining these two is minus 10 and we have plus 6 outside. So 6 into 6 lambda minus 10. Then plus 2 into 2 lambda plus 10 equal to 0. Now 8 we have to multiply, but before that we can group the like terms. So 8 minus lambda, here we have lambda square, and combining lambda term we get minus 10 lambda, and 21 minus 16 which is plus 5, and here we multiply inside, so 36 lambda minus 60 plus 4 lambda plus 20 equal to 0. Now let's multiply 8 inside. So 8 lambda square minus 80 lambda plus 8 is 40 minus lambda cube plus 10 lambda square then minus 5 lambda. Combining these two we get plus 40 lambda, and combining these two numbers we get minus 20, which is equal to 0. Sorry, this is minus 40. Now we notice plus 40 and minus 40 we can cancel. Apart from that, let's rearrange. So first minus lambda cube, then lambda square term we have to combine. So we have 2 lambda square term. After combining this, we get plus 18 lambda square. Then lambda term, if we combine, minus 80 lambda, minus 5 lambda and 40 lambda. So when we combine these things, we get minus 45. So after getting this, that is minus 45, lambda equal to 0. Let's change the sign throughout all the terms. So we get lambda cube minus 18 lambda square plus 45 lambda equal to 0. Now we can take lambda common. After that we get lambda square minus 18 lambda plus 45 equal to 0. From this, lambda equal to 0, and we get a quadratic expression, lambda square minus 18 lambda plus 45 equal to 0. Here the product is 45, sum is minus 18, so the two numbers are minus 15 and minus 3. So totally, when we make a product, we get plus 45, and when we add this, we get minus 18. So I'm going to write the factors directly. So one is lambda 0, and other is lambda minus 3 is one number, and lambda minus 15 is the another number. Now, equating individually to 0, we get lambda equal to lambda is 3 and lambda is 15. Another value of lambda is 0. So we got 3 eigen values. Those are 0, 3 and 15. Now we are going to find the eigenvector for each eigenvalue. So let's take 0. When lambda equal to 0, then A minus lambda I into eigenvector x1 equal to 0. And this is a A matrix. So using this, we are going to write A minus lambda I. So with all the leading diagonal elements, we have to put minus lambda. So now the lambda value is 0. So when we subtract 0 from this, once again we get the same element, that is 8, minus 6, 2, and minus 6, 7, minus 4, then 2, minus 4, and 3. And with this matrix, the eigenvector x1 is a column matrix which is having 3 elements, x1, x2, and x3. And other side, we have 0. Now, we are going to do the multiplication corresponding elements of first row with corresponding elements of this column we are going to multiply. So it is 8x1 minus 6x2 plus 2x3 equal to 0. In the same way, let's multiply the second row with corresponding elements of this column. We get minus 6x1 plus 7x2 minus 4x3 equal to 0. Two equations are sufficient to solve by cross multiplication method, where we take x1, we write the coefficient of x2, which is minus 6, 7, and coefficient of x3, which is 2 and minus 4. Let's take this as a determinant. Then x2 divided by, take the coefficient of x3, then coefficient of x1. In the same way, equal to x3, coefficient of x1, which is 8 and minus 6, and coefficient of x2, which is minus 6 and 7. Now we are going to evaluate this determinant. So x1, this is 24 minus 40, sorry, 24 minus 14. Then x2, this is minus 12 plus 32. And third one is x3, and this is 56 minus, this product is 36. So we have to subtract. Now x1 by 10, x2 by 20, x3 by 20. We are going to take the simplest ratio. So we divide by 10, we get x1 by 1, x2 by 2, and x3 by 2. So we got the eigenvector x1. The elements are 1, 2, and 2. Next, we are going to take the lambda value 3. When lambda equal to 3, we are going to find the eigenvector. So we use A minus lambda I matrix into the eigenvector x2 equal to 0. Here we have the matrix A, you take the leading diagonal, and with that we have to subtract the lambda value. So this will become 8 minus 3 and minus 6, 2, minus 6, 7 minus 3, minus 4, 2, minus 4 and 3 minus 3. The whole matrix into the eigenvector x1, x2, x3 equal to 0. Now this will become 5 minus 6, 2 and minus 6, 4 minus 4, then 2 minus 4 and 0. Now finally we have product of these two matrices. Now usual product method, we take the first row, we multiply the corresponding elements of this first column, we get an equation. So we get 5 x1 minus 6 x2 plus 2 x3 equal to 0. Then we take the second row and multiply with each elements of this column, we get minus 6 x1 plus 4 x2 minus 4 x3 equal to 0. Now these two equations are sufficient to use cross multiplication method to get the values of x1, x2 and x3. So x1 by coefficient of x2 is minus 6, 4, coefficient of x3 is 2 minus 4, then equal to x2 by coefficient of x3 which is 2 and minus 4, then x1 which is 5 and minus 6, then which is equal to x3 by coefficient of x1 which is 5 and minus 6, then coefficient of x2 which is minus 6 and 4. Now we are going to evaluate this determinant, and this will be x1 by 24 minus 8. Next will be x2 by minus 12, minus or minus will become plus, and 20. Then x3 by this 20 minus 36. So finally we get x1 by 16, x2 by 8 and x3 by minus 16. By taking the simplest ratio, we divide by 8, so we get this is 2 and this is 1 and this is minus 2. So 2, 1, minus 2, so we get the eigenvector x2 which is 2, 1, minus 2. Coming to the third eigenvalue, that is when lambda equal to 15, we are going to find the eigenvector by taking a minus lambda I into eigenvector x3 equal to 0. So once again, this lambda should be subtracted from the leading diagonal elements. So the first will be 8 minus 15. Then minus 6, 2 as it is. Then minus 6, 7 minus 15 and minus 4. Then 2 minus 4 and 3 minus 15. Then whole thing into the eigenvector x3, which is x1, x2, x3, and we have other side equal to 0. In subtracting this, we get 7, minus 6, 2, minus 6, 8, minus 4, 2, minus 4 and minus 12. The whole thing into x1, x2, x3, and the other side it is equal to 0. Sorry, this is minus 7 and minus 8. Now we are going to multiply this. So we take the first row and multiply with the corresponding elements of this column. So we are going to get an equation minus 7 x1 minus 6 x2 plus 2 x3 equal to 0. In the same way, let's take the second row and multiply with the corresponding elements of the this column elements. So we get minus 6 x1, minus 8 x2, minus 4 x3 equal to 0. Now these two equations are sufficient to get the values of x1, y1, x1, x2 and x3 by cross multiplication method. So x1 by coefficient of x2 which is minus 6, minus 8 and coefficient of x3 which is 2 and minus 4. Then x2 by here coefficient of x3 which is 2 and minus 4 and coefficient of x1 minus 7, minus 6. Then x3 by coefficient of x1 which is minus 7, minus 6. Then coefficient of x2 which is minus 6, minus 8. Now this will be x1 by this is 24 minus or minus will become plus and 16. And the second is x2 by minus 12 and minus of minus 20. Actually this product is 28 but we have to subtract, so minus 28. Then x3 by 56 minus 36. So we get x1 by 40, x2 by minus 40 and x3 by 20. Taking the simplest ratio, you can divide by 20, this will become 2, this will become minus 2 and this will become 1. So the eigen vector x3 has elements 2, minus 2 and 1. After getting these three eigenvectors, we are going to construct the model matrix P, which is made up of these three vectors. First column is made up of x1 which is 1, 2, 2. Second column is 2, 1, minus 2. Third column is 2, minus 2 and 1. Now, every column elements, sum of squares, we have to find within the root. So this will be root of 1 plus 2 square which is 4 and 2 square which is 4, which is root 9 and that is 3. In the same way, the second column elements we are going to find that will be root of 4 plus 1 plus 4 which is root 9, that is again 3. In the same way, the third column elements that will be root of 4 plus 4 plus 1, that will be again 3. So each element is divided by this root value, we get the normalized model matrix N, that is 1 by 3, 2 by 3, then 2 by 3. So all the first column elements is divided by this 3. In the same way, second column also we divide by 3, 2 by 3, 1 by 3 and minus 2 by 3. And even third column, 2 by 3, minus 2 by 3 and 1 by 3. So we got the normalized model matrix N. Now the formula for diagonalization D is N transpose into A N. So D equal to N transpose, we do the transpose of this matrix. We write the first row as first column, so 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 2 by 3, then second row as a second column, so 2 by 3, 1 by 3, minus 2 by 3, and third row as a third column, so 2 by 3, minus 2 by 3 and 1 by 3, it is a symmetric, so even after the transpose, it is the same thing, this multiplied with A, the matrix A we have taken from the question, then into N, once again the same thing will come because N and N transpose both are same. So 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 2 by 3, then 2 by 3, 1 by 3, minus 2 by 3, then 2 by 3, minus 2 by 3, and 1 by 3. So in this product, we are going to write the first matrix as it is. Then we are going to multiply these two matrix. So here we take the first row and multiply with the corresponding elements of the first column. So normal matrix multiplication where the common denominator is 3. So we take 3 and 8 into 1 which is 8, then minus 6 into 2 minus 12 plus 2 into 2 which is 4. Now coming to this first row, we multiply with the Second column, again the common denominator is 3. So we write by 3. Now it is 16 minus 6 minus 4. In the same way, we take the first row and multiply with the third column. So here again we take the common denominator 3. So this will become 16 and minus 6 into minus 2, so plus 12, then 2 into 1, so plus 2. Now same thing we have to do with the second row. So common denominator is 3, so minus 6 plus 14 minus 8. Then here also again 3 minus 12 plus 7 plus 8. Then the third column, again common denominator is 3, so it is minus 12 minus 14 minus 4. Then coming to the third row, again it is 3, so 2 minus 8 plus 6. Then this is 3, so 4 minus 4 minus 6. In the last element, which is 4 plus 8 plus 3. So we got the product and we are going to simplify this further. So this D is written as it is, that is D equal to this first matrix. In this simplification is, when we combine this, it is 12, 12, 12, 0. So the first element becomes 0. And here it is 16 minus 10. This is minus 10. So it is 6, 6 by 3, which is 2. And here it is 30. 30 by 3, which is 10. Now coming to the next one. These two combine, minus 14 plus 14, so 0. Even here it is 8 minus 8, 0. So we get the first column fully 0. Now here it is 15. 15 minus 12, 3. 3 by 3, which is 1. Then here it is minus 28. Sorry, minus 26 minus 4. So minus 30 and by 3. So minus 10. And here after cancelling this, we get minus 6 by 3, which is minus 2. Then here it is 15 by 3, which is 5. So finally, we got a matrix. This we are going to multiply with the n dash. So D equal to, in the same way, we take the first row and multiply with the corresponding elements of the first column. So everything will become 0, because 0 into anything is 0. Same thing we do with the second. In the common denominator is 3. So 2 plus 2 minus 4. Then with third column, common denominator is 3. So 10 minus 20 plus 10. Now taking the second row and multiplying with each column, once again this is 0. And this will be common denominator 3. So 4 plus 1 plus 4. Then coming to the next, it is common denominator 3. So 20 minus 10 minus 10. Then coming to the third row, which will be 0. By taking the product of all this thing, corresponding elements with the column, we get 0. Then common denominator is 3. So it is 4 minus 2 minus 2. Then the last one is, again common denominator is 2. So 20 plus 20 plus 5. So finally, we got a matrix which we are going to simplify the numbers. So D equal to, we get 0, and this is 2 plus 2 is 4, 4 minus 4, so this is 0. Then here it is 10 plus 10, 20 minus 20, so this is 0. Then here it is 0. When we add this, we get 9, 9 by 3, which is 3. Here everything gets cancelled. So 0 by 3 is, which is 0. This is 0. Here also everything it cancels 0. And this is 45 by 3, which is 15. So we got the diagonal matrix where we can find the leading diagonal elements are nothing but the eigen values which we got here, which is 0, 3 and 15. So we got the diagonal matrix. Then according to our question, we also have another thing to find, that is using this you have to find a power 4. For diagonalize the matrix we used the formula D equal to n transpose a n. From this we can find the value of when we multiply on both the sides with matrix n, that is pre-multiplying here and post-multiplying with n transpose. The same thing I have to do for this entire term, that is pre-multiplying with n, then rest of the terms as it is and post-multiplying with n transpose. Since if it is an orthogonal matrix, n into n transpose equal to I, in the same way n transpose into n is also I. So we get n into d into n transpose equal to, this part we can replace it with I and this part we can replace it with I. I is like identity matrix, I into a into I is once again we get a. So we got the value of a, which is n d n transpose. But we need a power 4. Suppose if I find a square from this, we have to multiply n d n transpose into n d n transpose. So here this product n transpose into n will give us I, and if I write the remaining, this is n, and this d into d will become d square, and the last term is n transpose. So when a square is n d square n transpose, in general a power n is n d power n n transpose. So we need a power 4. So let's take a power 4 equal to n d power 4 n transpose. Now let's substitute the values here. So we start from a power 4, that is a power 4 equal to n. Then we have to substitute d power 4. So d already we got the diagonalization as the diagonal elements 0, 3, 15 and the rest of the elements are 0. So when it comes to d power 4, it will become, I'll write it here, so d power 4 will become 0 power 4, which is 0, and the zeros are as it is, and this is 0, this is 3 power 4 and this is 0, 0, 0, 15 power 4. Then we have n transpose, and we write n transpose as 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 2 by 3, then 2 by 3, 1 by 3, minus 2 by 3, then 2 by 3, minus 2 by 3 and 1 by 3. Now we are going to continue the multiplication. Now our usual multiplication. So first matrix should be written as it is. We are going to make product of these two matrices. So we will write a power 4 and copy this first matrix. Now we take the first row and multiply with the corresponding elements of the first column. So everything is 0 here. So we can put 1, 0. Then everything is 0. If you multiply with the second column, it will be 0. Third column gives 0. Now coming to the second row and multiply with the corresponding elements of the first column, second column and third column. So once again, here if we see the first and last are 0. So we have to multiply only the middle term. So that will give 3 power 4 into 2 by 3. And coming to this, it is 3 power 4 into 1 by 3 and 3 power 4 into minus 2 by 3. So, I put minus here. So, 2 by 3. Then the last row, corresponding elements, we have to multiply and that gives, this is 0, 0 and we have 15 power 4 into 2 by 3. Then again 0, 0, then this will be 15 power 4 into minus 2 by 3. Then 15 power 4 into 1 by 3. So we completed the product of these two matrices. Now coming to this, we have to take the first row and multiply the corresponding elements of the first column. So this will be, first will be 0 because we are taking corresponding elements. First element, we multiply the first element, that gives 0. Second will be 2 by 3 into 3 power 4 into 2 by 3, then plus 2 by 3 into 15 power 4 into 2 by 3. So in the same way, we have to multiply the second column. That is, we take the first row and multiply the corresponding elements of the second column. So this will be, first part is 0 and second part is 2 by 3 into 3 power 4 into 1 by 3 plus 2 by 3 into 15 power 4 into minus 2 by 3. Then the third one, write it here. So first part is 0 anyway, and second part is 2 by 3 into minus 3 power 4 into 2 by 3. And last part is 2 by 3 into 15 power 4 into 1 by 3. In the same way, we take this and multiply with the corresponding elements of this. So here we are going to get, first is anyway 0. So we will write it here. So 0, then 1 by 3 into 3 power 4 into 2 by 3, then minus 2 by 3 into 15 power 4 into 2 by 3. Then the second one, it will be 0, then 1 by 3 into 3 power 4 into 1 by 3 minus 2 by 3 into 15 power 4 into minus 2 by 3. Then in the third row, it is 1 by 3 into minus 3 power 4 into 2 by 3 minus 2 by 3 into 15 power 4 into 1 by 3. Now we have to do for the third row and corresponding column. So we have first row and second row written. Now coming to this, minus 2 by 3 into 3 power 4 into 2 by 3 plus 1 by 3 into 15 power 4 into 2 by 3. Then minus 2 by 3 into 3 power 4 into 1 by 3. Then plus 1 by 3 into 15 power 4 into minus 2 by 3. Then minus 2 by 3 into, and this element is minus 3 power 4 into 2 by 3. Then plus 1 by 3 into, here it is 15 power 4 into 1 by 3. 15 power 4 into 1 by 3. So we completed the product, only simplification is remaining. So in this matrix, what are possible? Let's simplify this. 3, 3 is 3 square. If I cancel this, this will become power 2. So this will become 3 square, which is 9, 9 into 4. So the first term is totally 36. Even here, this 15 power 4 can be written as 3 power 4 into 5 power 4. So we can cancel 3, 3 and this will become 3 square. So we left with 2 into 3 square into 5 power 4 into 2. So this product gives 2, 2, 5, 0, 0. In the same way, let's cancel these two. This will become 3 square. So 3 square is 9, 9, 2. This is 18. And here in the same way, if I cancel this, this and this, the remaining will be 3 square into 5 power 4. But now we have negative. So this is minus 2, 2, 5, 0, 0. Then coming to the third one, again we can cancel these two. This will become 3 square. And now 3 square is 9, but this minus is separate. So we have minus 36. And this term, once again, there is no 2 here comparing to this. So it will be half of this with positive sign. So this will be 1, 1, 2, 5, 0. Now coming to the second row elements, we can again cancel. So 3 square. So 3 square is 9, 9, 2, 18, and minus. And this term and this term are same. After cancelling, we get minus 2, 2, 5, 0, 0. Then this after cancelling, this is 3 square, so which is 9. And here, this term and this first term are same. 2 by 3, 15 power 4 into minus 2 by 3. But anyway, both the negative make positive. So we can write plus 2, 2, 5, 0, 0. Then coming to this, once again, this after cancelling, we get 3 square, which is 9, 9 to 18, so minus 18. And this is similar to this one, 2 by 3, 15 power 4 by 3. But there is a minus sign, so minus 1, 1, 2, 5, 0. In this last element, once again after cancelling this, this is 3 square, so 3 square 9, 9, 4, 36. And let's see, similar to this, so that is here. So we have numerator 15 power 4 into 2, the denominator 9, so which is plus 11250. And here after cancelling this, this is 3 square, so total it is minus 18. And once again, this is similar to the term which is present here, and it is minus 11250. And the last element after cancelling this, this is 3 square, so it will become plus 36. And this is 15 power 4 by 9. After simplifying this, we get 5625. Now let's simplify these two and write it as a separate matrix. So in each case, the first element will be 36 plus 22500 will give 22536. And in the second one, it is 18 minus this, which is minus 22482. And the last one, it is 11250 minus 36. So we get 11214. And this one, already we have calculated the similar one. So 22482 with a minus sign. And this one just adding, so it is 22509, and this one both are minus, so 11268, and this one after subtracting 36 we get 11214. These both are negative, so minus 11268, and adding these two we get 5661. So after simplifying this, we got a power 4 as this matrix.